division we go. And this is going to be the Evil Empire's second chance to get a cup here as they will face the Benders. Welcome to RSHL, Daniel Wilson here. And like I said, the Evil Empire had a chance to get the Carolina Cup last season, but failed to do so to the Whalers. Last week, they had a rematch against them, and this time found a way by them, and now will have to face the Benders for the Cup. Last time, they had the services of Jim Tribus and Nett, but not this time. They're going to go with their regular goaltender, Greg Parlante. And it's nothing against him, because he is one that sees the whole floor, gives commands to his whole team, so watch for that. But at the same time, you got the snipers of the Benders. And they do have Jesse Wells back in their lineup, so we'll watch for that. Let's go to the breakdown with the Empire. I want to keep an eye, just like last time, Jan Greco. He has been a great goal scorer. So with him, I want to see him try to crash the net. This is one that the Benders are going to have to put focus their defense on. But in truth there, their points have been pretty spread around four different players. Hoffman, Jansen, and Reich. So watch for that.
Not me.
For the Benders. I want to keep an eye on Jesse Wells on this game. Just like in the B division, he has been back from injury. And let's see if he's got his full potential. They haven't been scoring as much as they should have been. But maybe with his services, they can remedy that. So that is it for this breakdown. The finals for the A division is next. Officials for this game, Brian Hooks, Donald Shaven, and Paul Pelka for this game. And with the amount of energy that these teams bring, they're going to need some grade A officials to control this. As we are now underway, McLaren's going to start off for the Benders, and he's going to just chip it down. Gino Giangreco, top points leader of the team, coming in with 21 points. And it's poked back in. And Giangreco took a tumble as he tried to keep the zone. Southern plays it back. Here's a shot saved by Parlante as he juggled it. Hey,
Jesse. We're just telling Ryan at least one of us will win something.
Hey, look. We're drinking a lot of beer.
And you probably heard Jesse Wells just note at least one of them will hold the Carolina Cup. They were teammates on the Reapers, but not this time. Reich is going to dump it down. Cassidy will go towards the slot and cut off. And here comes Wells, having Southern join him. Southern gets control. Now plays it back to McLaren. McLaren walks up, tries a long shot, he scores!
McLaren on the point! Gets the first goal of the game! And 1:13 in the first period!
Hey boys, pick it up! Come on now!
Head up, Greg!
Hey Greg!
5-2!
Scores,
head up!
5-2!
You're fine!
Yeah, the most likely reason that Parlante, glad that goes that he didn't see it. That's what the Empire think. So not much they can do about that. Nato connects over to Southern. Southern a shot saved by Parlante. Reich tries to clear. He does. Gets over to Hoffman. Hoffman will go over to Cassidy. Cassidy waits for everyone to get to their positions. And he was trying to connect over to Hoffman, and he lost control. Holding on, plays it back to Giangreco. Back up to Reich. Gets everyone forward, over to Cassidy. Facing Jesse Wells, Deke's around him. And that loose ball Deke did not work. It says put back into the Empire zone. Giangreco waits for everyone to tag. Now it connects up to Reich. Moving up and back over to Dan Greco, and it's going to connect over to Hoffman. Hoffman waits, now goes over to Cassidy. Cassidy connects over to Hoffman again. Shot just a little wide. May have gotten interrupted on the way. Right. We'll try to dance around. And he gave it away. And up it goes, cleared up, and that waves off the icing. It was going to reach Parlanti anyway. Dan Greco plays off the boards to Cassidy. And gets it across, but easily gave it away. McLaren will lob it up, and it will reach Parlanti. He'll drop it off. And it's back over to Reich. Returns over to Hoffman as they cross the center line. Cross it back over to Cassidy. Went off the foot of Jesse Wells, and they'll come back two against three defenders. Takes it wide behind the net. Sets up, takes a poke from Jan Greco. Shot saved by Parlanti. Plays back to McLaren. Holds up. Now takes a shot, that one wide, went off a foot. Resetting, now plays wide, intended that one for Nato. Hoffman takes over for the Empire, kicks it up, and reaches McLaren. And the Benders make a change. By the way, both teams playing with two subs today. Empire usually only have one or no subs, as it's been a problem that's cleared out of play. And this is going to stay inside the Empire zone. And roster depth has not been a problem for the Empire. That was a main concern all season. Playing backwards. And we'll connect over to Dan Greco. Dan Greco crosses and into the corner. McLaren picks up for the Benders. And playing forward, no icing on this play. The Empire wondering why that's not an icing. Oh, he left a wide open net! It is an easy go-go! Koga waves it off! Now what is going on here? And they're waving off the goal. What just happened here? So we'll try to get an explanation for that, but what the heck just happened? A lot of confusion on that play, but ultimately no goal for the Benders. And Jesse Wells picks it up, takes a poke from Rich. Wells with a shot wide of the net. Dan Greco will pick it up. Dances his way around. Dan Greco picks it up himself. Up to Hoffman. And Rich with speed will take it into the corner. Takes a look. Returns it to Hoffman. Takes it towards the slot. Shot a little wide. Rich picks it up for the Empire. Tries to set it up. That's blocked by Cowan, and he covers. It will be Reich against Banker Cove. Quick shot, and that's wide. And yeah, battle for control here. It's going to be Southern. He'll dance his way around. And now up against three defenders. And poke back, kept the line. Over to Wells. Takes a shot, that goes wide of the net. Might have been looking for Nato. And we'll go up to Cassidy, and he'll just poke it up across. McLaren will reset over to Southern. And he decides on a long shot. That's high at the net. As the Empire will make a change. Reich will pass it back to Dan Greco. Returns it to Reich. They keep the line. Drops it back to Hoffman. Shot! And that is a pad save by Cowan. And they're going to reset Banker Cove. They'll play it off the boards, and it will be given away to Gian Greco. They'll backhand it around to the other corner. 6.5 remaining in the first period over to Hoffman. And try to center up to Reich. And over to Cassidy, and that was tipped on the way, and it will be no icing on this play. Lobs it, glove down. Empire with control, over to Reich, crosses. Taking a look at two red jerseys, blocker save by Cowan. Over in the slot, that is lobbed out by Wells. Gian Greco resets over to Reich, crosses left. Now over to Reich, well, at least he intended to. And Wells cuts him off. Here they come the other way. Schaefner drops it back. Tries a shot, and that is a pad save as Wells tried to dive for it.
Ryan, you good? All right.
And the Empire win this face-off. Crossover to Hoffman, being pestered by Nato. He's joined by Rich, went off the foot. Schaefner, and it'll be covered up by Cowan with less than 5 remaining in the first. Reich tried a quick shot and managed to get it on net, and Cowan with a quick save. Reich wins it, backhands it off the foot of Wells, and picked up by McLaren. And it will be crossed over. Schaefner, and crosses over to Nato. Nato with a high shot, picked up by Steve Marino. Around the boards, picked up by Jesse Wells. Going up close at the slot, score! And Reich wins this face-off. Reno trying to connect up, taken away by Southern. Banker Cove will play it into the corner. Southern trying to dance around Marino. Marino gets it up to Rich, plays it off the boards. Down the floor it goes. McLaren takes a look, sees Rich with 3 minutes remaining in the first. Wells, and kept in by Gian Greco, but can't hold it. Wells picks it up. Facing four black jerseys, poked away, it'll be taken up by Hoffman. And they'll decide to backhand it, and Rich picks up on the play, goes into the corner, getting pestered by McLaren. And we'll play it across. Looking for a shot here, that is blocked. Hoffman plays over to Rich. They wanted him to shoot it, he didn't. Shot goes wide. Rich tries to center it and went off of Wells. Southern with control. Holding on, now takes a shot, went off the stick of Gian Greco. Gian Greco off the boards, intended for Cassidy, he gets it. Cassidy trying to dance around, looking at Baker Cove, drops it to Hoffman, saved by Cowan with 2 minutes remaining. Bad.
Bad luck over here.
Quick shot, score! J.I. Greco with the first goal for the Empire! The draw. Reich took a bump as he was trying to win that faceoff. He'll go to Marino. Dan Greco tries a shot wide of the net, less than a minute remaining. And he has to let it go for McLaren. McLaren lobs it, taken up by Marino. And we'll play it over to Reich, waits for it, hop into tag, he does. Trying to dance around Vankerko, but can't get past another. Dan Greco plays off to Hoffman. Trying to get around McLaren, he can't. Three on two the other way, but stolen by Hoffman. Hoffman up to Reich. Tries the turn and go, and it was offside against the Benders. They had the tag. Hoffman with 15 seconds remaining and drops it, nobody there. Southern tries to get around Marino, he clears it. And he's going to lob it in, but it's an offside shot. So that would not have counted anyway. And that does it for the first period. A good first period. The Benders are up 2-1. Ready for the second period to get underway. Benders up 2-1. After a frustrating start for the Empire, but they did get on the board thanks to Jan Greco. And Rich will start us off for the second period. Plays it back to Jan Greco. And Cassie tried to bat it down, but it couldn't. Wells, backhands up, glove down by Marino. But it is a hand pass, and this is gonna come back. Dan Greco will get it, and he'll play it off the boards to Rich. Rich trying to dance around Schaffner. Back to Dan Greco, shot goes wide. Cassidy will pick it up. He'll try to dance around Wells. Drops it to Reich. They can't quite control it. Dan Greco trying to help him out, but to no avail. Benders the other way. Southern will center it up. Shot, and that is wide of the net. And Parlanti coming out, making sure he stays in the crease to avoid the delay of game. And it's a tie up in the bench. Elia John Greco and clears it out of the zone, and that forces Jesse Wells to come back and pick it up from John Cowan. It will be Wells, he'll walk it up. Wait for everyone to set up, lobs it up. Intercepted by Jan Greco, dancing around McLaren. He got a chance, can't control it. Into the corner, poked back by Reich. Jan Greco tries again, sends it over to Hoffman. Sliding block by Wells, here they come the other way, Schaffner. Trying to get around Hoffman, can't get through. Schaffner still has control. Plays it back to Southern. Takes a bump from Reich. Plays it behind the net. Hoffman getting double teamed. Back in the corner. We'll take a look. Sees a man open, but intercepted by Reich. And poked back, but the Benders are offside. They have to tag. Dan Greco with control. Now play it off the boards. To Hoffman, try to get a return, taken away. Crosses over, sets up, shot, and that is high and wide.
Hey, 91.
And intercepted by Hoffman, that pass was off. Backhands to Cassidy. Cassidy sends over to Reich, that pass was off. Here comes Nato. Nato coming wide, shot saved by Parlanti. And cleared out by Gian Greco. And a little battle for control here. Bender still have it. Back at the point. Southern with a shot. And went off the glove and is up on the safety netting. Rebound chance. Score! Steve Nato! 3-1 Bender! And Nato picks up number 3 of the season. And what happened there as Banker Cove lost his stick? And that's going to be lobbed out. Parlanti will drop it off. And Rehquist taken down away from the play, and a penalty is coming up. Oh, what is going on at center here? Rich is upset at Banker Cove. I don't know for what reason. There was just no reason for that, and because of that, he's going to the box as well. That was just unnecessary. So it's going to be both Banker Cove and Rich. And, oh, it was a cross check. So it was a cross check that now makes this a 4-on-4. So what could have been a power play turns into a man down for each side.
Oh, I'm sorry, I thought it wasn't there.
And they're just waiting for the penalties to be assessed on the board. On the draw, and it is gonna be Hoffman with control. Shot saved by Cowan. Rebound and a great stop, and a penalty is coming up against the Benders. Gian Greco with a shot that is blocked, and a penalty being assessed to the Benders, and it is a slash.
Be smiling. P.S. Needed that power play.
I don't play that.
Are you serious?
And who's going to get assessed this penalty? It is going to be Steve Nato heading to the box. It'll be 4-on-3 for the next minute 43 seconds, but it will be a full 2-minute power play for the Empire. Shot saved by Cowan. And that's a high stick. And we're going 3-on-3. Wow. This is a rarity, a 3-on-3 coming up.
Black 32,
yeah. So look at all that room that has been placed on the ice. This is certainly a rarity in the RSHL. Yeah, look at the penalty box. I wonder how many we can fit in here.
My fault, boys. That's it until they're
done. And so we are going into NHL overtime style now. It will be the Benders with control here. They got a lot of room to work with. Over to McLaren. Gets a return.
Patch up!
And we played back.
Watch him, Ryan.
And we'll backhand it around the boards. Over to Jesse Wells. and backhands it over to Southern. Shot goes high, tries to rebound, score! 4-1 Benders, and we are gonna remain a 3-on-3.
No, we would stay.
Yep, we would we're stay. Even strength.
So he should come out. He should come out.
Getting a little anxious there on the dot, and it will be won by Reich. Dan Greco over to Cassidy. Gives the return. And it went off a foot, but it gets to Cassidy. Trying to get a close-up shot, but can't quite control it as Southern swings it. I'm sorry, Cowan swung his stick around.
Good job!
And you don't see goaltenders do that often. Usually, they do it to stop any kind of pass. But to swing it to the, all the way to the back of the net, here's a shot that goes high. He tries to get it in, score! Dan Greco gets it back to the 4-2. On the drop. So, Bankerco and Ridge are getting ready to come out of the box. We're going to go 4-on-4 momentarily, but only for about 7 seconds. Here they come out of the box. 5 seconds remaining on the 4-on-4. And NATO is coming out of the box, and it now becomes a short power play. Do they even have enough time to get one off? Here's NATO. Shot, save! Rebound, another save! Chaos by the net! It was certainly chaos by the penalty box. So we had the floodgates open for both teams. And the Empire win this draw. Hoffman with control. Cross over to Reich. Returns to Rich, but intercepted, cleared out. Off the boards. And Hoffman able to hold the line. A cross over to Rich, drops it to Reich. And he will get a return, but the pass is off. And now has to deal with Jesse Wells in the corner. Reich backhands it, calls up shot, and a save by Cowan. Trying to get some help, traffic in front. Knocked down by Marino, and that is tipped high. Taking a look. Cross over to Reich. Oh, he can't get the shot off. Tries again as he's taken down. Here's Hoffman with another shot that goes wide. Jesse Wells with control for the Benders. Less than 6 remaining in the second period. Marino. Oh, across around, and now Schaefner taking control. Looking at a shot that is blocked. And they try to clear, knocked down by Jesse Wells. Shot, glove save up in the air, and Parlanti covers.
Good job, Greg.
Back to NATO and a quick save by Parlanti. Another shot that is blocked.
Take it up.
Hoffman cuts off Wells. Gets double teamed. Shot by Wells goes wide. Picked up by Dan Greco. And we'll play it off the boards. Here comes Cassidy. Has to race down NATO. NATO wins the race. We'll play it off to McLaren. And moving in was Reich, went off of Dan Greco. He has to pull back.
On air!
Hoffman with control as Cassidy tags up. Hoffman, pass over to Cassidy. Back over to Dan Greco. He's looking for a trick. Back to Cassidy. Trying to get it to Reich, picked up by Schaffner. Dan Greco waits for everybody to tag up. Hoffman and Cassidy tag. We'll play it over to Reich as he goes down rink. Reich will play to the right end boards.
Come on, guys, move!
Trying to get everyone into position, still holding on to that ball. Now plays to the corner. Cassidy picks up. Centers one, and Reich couldn't get there in time. Jan Greco plays it around. Intended for Cassidy, gets there. Marino with a shot, gloss save! Oh, and that was a slash by Cowan! That was undisciplined! And is... That was a clear slash by Cowan, and officials are gonna talk this over. It looks like this is gonna go unpenalized unless they... Unless they say something here, this is going to go unpenalized here. I don't know what that was about. That was undisciplined. Cowan's got to be more careful. As the offenders win this face-off, back over to Marino. It'll be Southern. Backhands it out. Down the floor it goes. Parlanti. Taking a look, Marino moving in, trying to cut off. And what is going on back there? Oh, this could get some trouble here. Look at the net. As Parlanti gets through, look out here. And we're gonna get some penalties here. It is, yeah, both of them are going to the box here. That is undisciplined. So we're gonna go back to 4-on-4. It'll be a roughing penalty to both, and that is Vanker Co's second penalty of the game. And we'll be back to Rich for the Empire. As emotions are now getting in the way of their play time. Wells with control. Tries a shot and a save by Parlanti. Yeah. Tries to dance around and knocked away by Gian Greco. And here they come, 2-on-1. Hoffman. Pass over to Rich, at least he intended to, and crashes. Here's Reich. Tries a shot and diving across. Here's Hoffman. Hoffman tries a shot, that is blocked. Tries to center it, intercepted. 2-on-1 the other way. And he's going all alone here, shot, saved by Parlanti. Ailey backhanded, but can't quite clear the zone. Shot, that is high. Jan Greco bats it down, we'll play it off the boards. A minute remaining in the penalties, a minute 50 in the period. Reich will pick it up. We'll try to get around. He does. Plays it back to Nato and over to Schaefner. Schaefner will play it off the end boards, and Parlanti is just going to drop it off to Jan Greco. Over to Reich. Can't control it. McLaren. Pass it over to Southern. Southern will drop it back. Nato with a shot. That's wide of the net, and they're telling him to play it. Nobody near him. Jan Greco passes up to Reich. And not hard enough of a pass. They'll dub it back. As we approach a minute remaining in the second period. Yeah. 5 seconds left. And Jan Greco goes through, and it is... And it is an offside against the Empire, so they'll have to wait till they come out on the drop.
Steve, I'll get the door. You can just go ahead and unhook it.
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, but go ahead and unhook it. Run right out.
And off they go. And it is out of play, and it's going to come back.
Oh my goodness.
It'll be play back with 8 seconds remaining, backhand and cover it up, and there's not going to be enough time for a drop. So emotions boiling here. The Benders are going to go into the second intermission with a 2-goal lead, 4-2 after two. We go into the third after a penalty-filled second period. Banker Cove has accumulated 2 penalties, 1 more, and he is gone for the game. Back over to McLaren as we start off the third. Off the boards, and just barely kept that stick down. Any higher, he would have been thrown out of the game. Jan Greco will drop it back. Gonna take a look, wait for everybody to set up. Now we'll play it off, and it hits the safety netting, slowing it down. It'll be picked up and poked out by McLaren. We'll play it off. And trying to clear it out, and it's gonna go over to Gian Greco. Play down, over to Rich, drops it to Reich. He'll decide to play it off the boards, race between Rich and Wells. Nato trying to clear, he does. Back to Gian Greco. Is now it's just focusing on trying to get it started. It's poked again by Banker Cove. Went off of official Donald Shaven. And we'll play back over to Rich. Got the stick lifted. Back over to Reich. Shot. Pad save by Cowan. And we'll play it off. Cassidy trying to get a shot. It is played back. And a fight for control. And it will be Gian Greco. Back to Reich. Yes, barely kept it onside. They come around the boards. McLaren. And we'll play it up. And out it goes. And Dan Greco is going to chase this one down. Still need to accumulate 2 in this period. We'll play it to his left. Cassidy trying to dance around. Can't quite get through, but gets it to Reich. Tries a shot, glove save, and Hoffman trying to look for a rebound. Here's another one that is deflected high. Up in front, and over to, oh, and a collision. And that involved Wells, and it looks like Hoffman, I know he didn't mean to do that. Wells is not that kind of person to do that intentionally. Yeah, that was Cassidy, actually, that was involved there. Back to Marino. Gian Greco with a long shot, save. Tries another, trying to look for those rebound chances. It'll be taken away by Southern. Going at 2 and up against 4 jerseys. Now as Reich and Hoffman join in. It'll be played off, and it went off the side of the net. Reich, well, backhanded over to Rich. Rich trying to get around McLaren, can't quite get through. It'll come back over to Marino. He'll drop it to Gian Greco. And I don't know where he's trying to pass it to. Communication, guys. It is Marino over to Gian Greco. 11 minutes remaining in the third period. Over to Hoffman. Gets double teamed, passes it to Reich. Trying to dance around there. The Benders coming with an aggressive defensive strategy now. As they wait for the setup, poked by Reich. They're gonna try again. Rich has knocked down, but he can't play it yet as Schaefner was offside. Gian Greco going on the attack, and it's a save by Cowan, and he'll cover. It's between Reich and Southern as Reich got pushed down and it's aired out. And Parlanti's going to come out and cover that up. He's trying to force his hand there and that's going to force a drop in the Empire zone. You notice Southern playing way outside, but that's going to hit the ceiling. Southern was all the way on the other circle. And the Empire warning him about it. As the Empire gain control, they try to clear. They do, and Wells touched it. That waves off the icing. Wells takes it to the boards and will play it towards center. Reich tries to poke it back and returns it up. Over to Southern, being chased by Reich. Waiting for instructions, goes to Wells. Long shot, saved by Parlanti. And back over to Wells in his own end. 8:30 remaining in regulation. Schaffner with control. And trying to get through, he does, intercepted by Marino. Hoffman gets poked by McLaren, he'll lob it. Over to Cassidy, trying to get around Wells. Does he have the speed to do that? Tries a shot, and it reaches Cowan, and he covers. And a toss up, and looks like the Empire have control. Tried to get it to Reich, but it went off a foot. Banker Cove trying to poke it away. And still battling for control. He does get it out. Gian Greco races down and will pick it up. Gian Greco waits for everyone to reset. Now will carry himself. And will center it to Reich. Reich, seeing McLaren looming over, gave it away to Nato, and he'll clear it down the floor. Gian Greco taking a look. Here's Hoffman calling him out as they will make a change. Around the boards, and it's going to be given away to Vanker Cove. Shot wide of the net. Hoffman picking up in his own corner and will pass it back to Gian Greco, and he gets a return. Hoffman going three against four defenders. Went off the foot of Vanker Cove. He's going to take it himself. Now passes to Rshl. Shot! He got pushed down. And you don't see any hands going up. And it's going to be an attempted clear. Glove down by Marino. Oh, through the legs. Shot! Score! Another step in the road back. 4-3. It is Hoffman with the goal, and now the Empire find themselves in a very familiar position. This is exactly the score that was in last season's final. So this is a very familiar position for the Empire. Reich tries to get through, plays it back. Gian Greco. And over to Rshl. Back over to Gian Greco. Was thinking about a shot, instead goes corner. Rshl. Getting pestered by Banker Cove. Will play it around to Hoffman. Tries a shot, and that is wide of the net. Rshl takes a look. Sees Banker Cove looming over. Now decides on a shot himself. That is blocked by Banker Cove. Plays it back over to Marino. Marino sets up shot, and that is why the net went off the glove of Cowan. Hoffman behind the net, over to Reich. Gave it away to Wells, plays off the boards. Reich picks it up again, sends it up! What a save! He has committed grand theft! Back over to Wells as Cowan keeps this a one-goal game for the Benders. It's been deja vu for the Empire. Hoffman. Oh, cross it over. Cassidy beating Nato as they get to a change. Southern moving up, take it away. Hoffman can't play the ball yet, waiting for an attack. Now he gets it. Reich got poked, picks up himself, backhands it. Cowan, it will cover that up with 4:10 remaining. A lot of familiar occurrences in this game compared to last season's final, but the difference is that the Empire have plenty of time remaining. 4 minutes left. They got plenty of time to score that game-tying goal. Banker Cove will dump it down the floor. And Parlante waiting for Gian Greco, now gives it to him. Crosses over to Hoffman. We'll play backwards as they reset. Hoffman gets the return. Tries to get around Wells, unable. So we'll clear it back out. We will be at a stop clock at the 3 minute mark. Gets through traffic. Gets over to Cassidy, intercepted. McLaren through center. See Southern looming over, decides to take the shot himself, and a save by Parlante. He decides to cover as we approach the 3 minute mark. It will be a stop clock from this point out, and the Empire call their timeout. The Empire are just trying to figure out how to get through the back check, as that seems to be the only problem they're having. They also need to keep their tempers in check, as we've had a total of 6 penalties handed out tonight. And so and one of those penalties had caused a potential power play. With 3:05 remaining, that's plenty of time for them to get one. We will watch Parlante from this point out. Empire coming into the final for the second season in a row. They failed on their first attempt. They are trying to redeem themselves here on their second attempt at their Carolina Cup run. At 3:05, there'll be a stop clock from this point out.
That was black all the time.
Correct.
And it looks like it's going to be Reich to take this face off. And he wins it for the Empire. They try to clear, unable to. But it does get to Rich, and he'll pass it over to Reich. 3-on-2. Pass it back to Rich. Shot saved by Cowan. Reich moves in, will play it around to Rich behind the net. Wells trying to stop him. Trying to shank off Wells, unable to. And play it off the netting. That slows it down just enough for Reich to play it. Back to Gian Greco, tries a shot that is blocked. Reich with control, backhands it. Glove save by Cowan, he swats it away. Over to Hoffman in the corner. Hoffman carries towards the slot, gets bumped into by McLaren. They try to clear, unable. Kept in the zone, backhands it across, that passes off. Nato will dump it in. And Parlante will drop it off for Gian Greco. And that is too far of a pass, and it is going to be an icing against the Empire with 2:02 remaining.
Best hands on the team.
You what?
Best hands on the team.
Yeah.
And Gian Greco will take it. He'll play it up to Cassidy. Banker Cove upset, but he didn't stop that. And it's an offside. And the Empire showing their displeasure at that call, but rather lightheartedly. And played it back. McLaren unable to hold the line, is forced to play it forward. Dan Greco will play it over to Hoffman. Hoffman trying to dance around, unable to get through Wells. They try to clear. Taken up by Marino. Shot that is blocked. Dan Greco can't get a clear shot. Marino, and that is blocked by Nato. Can they hold the line? No, they can't. Cassidy holding up. And now we'll play back. Reich over to Rich. And there goes Parlanti. 6-on-5 now. Rich moving in. Picked up. Shot. Right in front of the net. Wells trying to clear it. Taken down. No call yet. Behind the net. They try to clear up. And it is heading towards the net. No, just a little wide. And they say no icing on this play. Marino playing around. 50 seconds remaining in the third period. Gave it away. Tries again on the empty net. Wide. They're going to have to push on all cylinders now. Reich playing on the boards. Dances through. Got a chance. Poked away. Taken down. No call. On the boards. Down the floor it goes. 25 seconds remaining.
Come on, come on.
And they're going to try one more time here. Knocked down by Nato. He's got an open net to try. 10 seconds left. Do they have enough time? 5 seconds left. They're going to have to put in everything. Long shot by Dan Greco. And the banner. Again, it was a great effort by the Empire, but in the end, it was deja vu. They end their season on the same end as last time. And the and the Benders will once again get to hold that cup for another season.
Hey, thanks for
having me, guys. Let's talk to you about that.
And they will once again take home the Carolina Cup.
I gave them their last goal too. So
a 4-3 win will end up the season. And we'll be back with a wrap up.
Here with Jesse Wells of the Benders. The first question I have to ask for everyone is, how's the knee?
It's getting better. It's feel strong. I'm actually without a brace now, which is, you know, a step in the right direction, I'd imagine. I'm still a little hesitant. I don't think my speed is quite, you know, back to 100%, but it's good enough, I guess.
Yep. Yeah, that's been our main concern of this game. Has that affected your ability at all this game?
Yeah, I would say I'm not as fast. My cuts, I'm not that burst to get going. That first step isn't quite there yet. It's getting there. Hopefully, I'll be 100% for next season.
Well, we can pretty much say that you're not going to make any friends with the Empire anytime soon after what's happened to this game. But they have made their second run to the Carolina Cup this season. Do you think they've gotten any better?
Oh, well, they're a great team. I mean, they've been at the top of the standings all year. I think we played them two or three times. I think a few of the times they beat us like 7-2. They're a great team. They're going to stay a great team. They'll be great back here next year in town before again.
So I think the last thing I need to say before we end this off is take care of that knee, and we'll see if we do even better for the next
season.
Yeah,
hey man, yeah, let's go for it again. Why not?
Yeah, so we will see you the next season.
Right.
And that goes the same with you guys. Thanks for joining us for a great season. We'll be back in the spring for a whole new season. I'm Daniel Wilson from XL Sports World. We'll see you guys next time around.
The RSHL is supported by AllBlackHockeySticks.com, the stick of choice for many players of the RSHL. It's a very light and durable stick for only $89. AllBlackHockeySticks.com.